all of you. This is my son, Patrick Goods, coming to you from St. Patrick's Catholic Church, Oakland, California. Wishing you happy Easter and a wonderful, inspiring Mass. May God bless all of you. St. Patrick's Catholic Church, Oakland, California.
Thank you. a reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter proceeded to speak and said, "You know what has happened over all Judea, beginning in Galilee, after the baptism that John preached. How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power. He went about doing good and healing all those oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses of all that he did, both in the country of the Jews and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. This man, Jesus, God raised on the third day and granted that he be visible, not to all the people, but to us, the witnesses chosen by God in advance, who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commissioned us to preach to the people and testify that he is the one appointed by God as judge of the living and the dead. To him, all the prophets bear witness that everyone who believes in him, will receive forgiveness of sins through his name. This is the word of the Lord.
Not of what is on earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, your life, appears, then you too will appear with him in glory. The word of the Lord.
Ever told. As we've remembered the extravagant gestures of love that Jesus has shown us. We've been there with the beloved disciple on Holy Thursday as he rested his head on the heart of Jesus at the Last Supper. We've been there with Peter as he had his feet washed and then went on to deny his best friend. And we were there with Mary Magdalene at the foot of the cross, where that living water flowed from the heart of Jesus. And today we're with those disciples again, Peter and John and Mary Magdalene, as they discover that empty tomb and they ask the question, where is Jesus? Where is Jesus? That's our question for today. Where is Jesus? This gospel reading that we heard today is from the Gospel of John. And this question, where is Jesus, is a very common question in John's gospel. At the beginning of the gospel, the disciples ask Jesus, where do you live? Where do you stay? And they keep asking this during the gospel until the Last Supper, when they're really puzzled about what Jesus is saying about going home to the Father. They don't understand where he's going. Those characters, the characters in John's gospel, are kind of like the characters in that Old Testament book called the Song of Songs, which is like a love poem in the Old Testament. It tells the story of these two lovers who are searching for each other. And they're asking the question, where is the one that I love? Where is the one that my heart desires? And they go searching for each other through the city streets until they finally are reunited in this beautiful garden. And today we heard the story of Mary Magdalene going to a garden where she sees the empty tomb. And she runs back to those disciples and she tells them, they've taken Jesus, the one that I love, and I don't know where they put him. And Peter and John have this similar deep love for Jesus. And they ask the question. They run to that empty tomb and they ask the question, where is Jesus? Where is the one that we love? The one that we denied just the day before? The one that we love? The one that we want to see again? Where is he? In my imagination, I can picture John and Mary and Peter singing one of those songs that we sometimes sing here at St. Patrick's. I pray for you, you pray for me, I love you, I need you to survive.
Let go of the way she knew Jesus before, that
Jesus challenges her to meet him in a new way. He challenges her to meet him in his brothers and sisters, in his people. Mary Magdalene's challenge is our challenge too. Can we love each other? Can we love our brothers and sisters the way Jesus loves us? Can we love them passionately the way we love Jesus? Can we keep our promises to our spouses, to our children, to our community members, the way Jesus kept his promise to us and stood by us, even in the face of torture and death? Can we really live and die with Jesus? I believe that we can. I believe we can live and die with Jesus because he lives and dies with us. Because Jesus is with us, we can love our brothers and sisters in the face of any obstacle, any fear, any power of darkness. The light of Christ outshines any fear, any danger, any obstacle.
Thank you. I need you to survive. You are important to me. Oh, hallelujah, and I need you to survive.
That the church experienced a profound renewal in the risen Lord and boldly proclaimed his marvels to every nation, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That those who govern offer justice and compassion to those placed in their care, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That those who have received the Easter sacraments encounter Christ in every member of their community, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That all who have died share the Lord's victory over death and live forever in the peace of Jesus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That all here present who joyfully celebrate the Paschal mystery bear witness to the resurrection with renewed enthusiasm, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Our prayer intentions for Wilfred Taylor, Otis Dixon, Edna Howard, Dorothy Grant, Earl Dorsey, John Larkin, Manuel Tolar, Lily Sousa, Wallace Jones, Gladys Williams, Sister Pat Phelan, LaBella Devereaux, Ella Pearson, Virginia Campbell, Teresa Henry, Raymond Henry, Laura Sutton, Imelda Jones, Jesse Jackson, Father Charles Burns, Marcia Cooper, sister of Marilyn Atkins, Debbie King, Brittany Mouton, and Rosie De La Cruz, and Louise Roots. Mass attendance, Dorothy Riley, Jenny Barrett, and Mary E. Pierre. For what else shall we pray for?
Lord, hear our prayers.
I pray for this day of the Lord, the celebration of his resurrection, and for saving us, going through all those troubles of pain and suffering, just to save us. I pray for my family, my church family, my family,
by in the silence of our hearts, that you gather these prayers together, and if it is your will, that you grant what we ask, the Spirit of the risen Jesus. We ask all this in his name. Amen. blesses through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let's give thanks to the Lord our God.
His blessing and thanks and praise.
All power and glory be God, we do well always and ever to give you thanks through Jesus Christ our Lord. We praise you with greater joy than ever on this Easter season when Christ became our Paschal sacrifice. He is the true Lamb who took away the sins of the world. By dying, he destroyed our death. By rising, he restored our life. And so with all the choirs of angels in heaven, proclaim your glory and join in their unending hymn of praise.
Thank you.
reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by his body and blood may be filled with his Holy Spirit and become one body, one spirit in Christ. And may he make us an everlasting gift to you, enable us to share the inheritance of all your saints with Mary, the Virgin Mother of God, the Apostles, the Martyrs, St. Patrick, all your saints of this blessed procession, be alive and for help. Lord, may the sacrifice which made our peace with you advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Strengthen in faith, strengthen in love your pilgrim church on earth, your servant Pope John Paul, and bishops John and Alan and all your bishops, with the clergy and the entire group your son has gained for you. Father, dear Christ, the family you have gathered here before you, in mercy and in love, unite all of your children, wherever they may be. Welcome into your kingdom, our blessings, all the hope this world in your flesh. We hope to join for the vision of your Lord. We hope to join for the vision of your glory, Christ our Lord, whom all good things come.
2015. That's how you come doing so well.
Thank you. Thank you. That's the angel. And this is the mother. I'll give you a copy of this tape, okay?
Okay.
Thank you.
dad were married here. So he's a Old St. Patrick's boy.
Amen.
Patrick is. St. Patrick's Catholic Church. Wishing you bless. Prosperous. God bless.